Thank you, Donna. Well, you can't teach an old dog new tricks, or can you? According to our next guest, dog training is not about the dogs, but about the owners. And she says anyone can easily train their dog. Oh, to show us how, please welcome animal behaviourist Laura V. Laura, thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
So, I just said in the introduction, it's about the owners, not the dogs. What do you mean by that?
Dog training is not about dogs at all.
It's really?
It's all about people, because we basically shape everything that they do. For example, if you let your dog pull on the lead, then they'll tend to pull more and more and more.
Okay.
So it's about
I did the wrong thing.
Yeah, you did the wrong thing.
So I'll let it go.
Don't let go. So what we need to do is think from their point of view. Everything that they do, they're trying to communicate with us. So we need to have some empathy and some respect and some leadership and be consistent. So if you don't want your dog to do something, don't reinforce it. If you do want your dog to do something, then reinforce those behaviours. So what we did then, Robbo, is we actually reinforced her pulling on lead.
Yes.
But we actually want to reinforce her not pulling on lead.
So...
does that make sense?
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
So take us through now. Iggy. So Iggy has a tendency to jump on people, is that right?
Yeah, she sure does. So we've been reinforcing it today because we want her to jump up. Hey, Iggy. Come here. Hey.
So now she's not going to jump
on us. There we go. Okay. So what's happened is, because she's only 1 year old, so, you know, for the past...
Oh!
You're right.
Yeah.
Oh, so great with animals, aren't you?
Well,
I work with you.
Yeah.
So, you know, for months and months, she's been reinforced. When she was a puppy, she would jump up. It was cute. People would pat her. They'd give her attention. She's learnt that when she wants something, she jumps up and she gets it.
Okay.
So what we want to do is we want to teach her that when she has 4 feet on the floor, that's when she gets what she wants. In fact, Iggy, come here. Iggy, come here. We start to ignore it. We don't give her what she wants. She forgets about it. And then when she can see that there's an opportunity for her to get what she wants... there we go.
Aww.
Wow.
Good girl.
See, it's all about the person. It's got nothing to do with the dog at all. So every time she does what I want, I reinforce that behaviour.
What are you feeding her?
Wait, what's a treat?
Chicken.
Ooh, yummy.
Oh, wow.
Free-range roast chicken. Yep. So there you go. So now... she's starting to offer that behaviour. I'm not asking her to sit.
You turn away.
I turn away. I don't even look at her, I don't say anything. She gets nothing from me.
Ooh!
So no reaction at all. There's no voice reaction.
Nothing.
There's
nothing. Because even if you say no, what does no mean to a dog? They don't speak English.
Yeah. What do they speak?
They speak dog.
They speak dog, yeah.
They do. So we have to learn how to speak dog. Sit. Good girl.
Good girl.
So this is the only time that she gets rewarded.
Okay. That's what she does. And you ignore
her. And then she'll learn really, really quickly. Oh. You have to make sure also that you have something that motivates your dog. If you try and give them dry kibble, they're like, whatever.
Yep.
But if you give them something that they love, then they're going to offer the behaviour that you want. So every time they're doing the right thing, capture the moment and reinforce that moment. Every time they do the wrong thing, consistently ignore it. Even 1 out of 100 times that you reinforce it, you're still reinforcing it, making it more and more confusing, making the behaviour worse and worse.
Now, we've got Spoo here, is this correct?
This is Spoo.
And you're going to teach a new trick.
We are. So I thought I'd teach the guys at home a really cute trick. Oh, look at this, guys. Did you see that behaviour?
Aww.
She's offering to lie down, which is fantastic. We want to capture that behaviour. With Spoo, I'm going to get him to jump through a kissing booth.
Well, this will be the most action I've got in a while, but okay. I'll take it where I can get it.
Out of the way. So I thought about something that the kids could do at home during the school holidays.
We're actually gonna
pop Spoo around this side.
Just around here, but
we'll go around the other side.
A little bit nervous, a little bit awkward. Okay, over here, darling.
And what we're gonna do is we're gonna do what's called target training.
Mm-hmm.
So we teach our dog to put their nose to the hand, and then food magically appears out of your hand. Touch. And you can do this at home. It's really good to build a dog's confidence. So touch and reward. Touch, and then they get food from the other hand. Touch. Good boy.
Is it time for a kiss yet?
Yeah, I reckon.
I'm in the mood.
Who's first?
Robbo.
Come on.
Yep.
He won't mind.
All right, are you going to be there too?
Oh, I don't know. Do you want me down here? do you want me to...
No, I'll just... yeah, maybe I'll just... I don't know. Okay. So I just
put your head right in there. Come on. Right. Don't be shy. There we go.
Oh, my goodness.
Right. Aww.
There we go. How cute is this for kids to do at home with their dog?
Well, it smells like chicken, so that's good. And it's wet.
Isn't that beautiful?
It's so a beautiful, beautiful moment.
It is a beautiful moment. There you go.
Yeah. That's enough dogs for me.
And it's full of dog slobber, so there you go. So just a really cute trick that you can put your dog on.
No, thank you. And if you'd like to learn more tips and tricks on exactly how to train your dog, you can grab Laura's fantastic book, which is called Things Your Dog Wants You to Know. Thank you once again, Laura. Much appreciated.